Okay, listen. Let us get introduced to something like a new device that we will be required, that we will need for conducting some experiment like diode clipping, clamping. You have had enough idea, right? You have had enough idea of something like this. We have seen the characteristics of this, right? So I'm recapping something like how does this behave? It behaves as an insulator at the very first 0.1 to 0.3 volt or so, right? We have seen in the characteristics tab that it used to behave something like this. Listen, it used to behave something like this. At a very, once we apply voltages, up to certain volt value, there has been no current, right? So as there was no current, that means it behaves as an insulator. It doesn't allow the current to pass through this, right? So it is an insulator by now. Okay. And after a certain value, it start rising current. That means it start conducting. And after a certain time, it behaves as a full conductor. That means a diode can behave either insulator or conductor, right? Okay. It can be forward biased or it can be reverse biased. Okay, I ask you a question. That is, how could you make a diode forward biased? Which is a very simple thing. That means if you connect the p-type and n-type with a positive supply, then this positively charged particle will push this positive holes to the junction, and this negative will push the electrons to the junction. That's how this barrier will eliminate at certain voltage, right? So listen, I'm telling you what, be careful about your study, because listen, I mean, once you make a good grade, you will have lot of opportunities open for you. If your academic status is good, there are lots of facilities, I mean opportunities for you once you finish the graduation. But once you have a poor grade, this will just throw you to the hell. There is no way. You are just spending money here, right? You're paying off. So you should at least take some advantage out of it. University level education is like a quite, you know, top level education, I mean higher level education. It's not a primary level, so you should concentrate on, like, you are a higher educational students. Your behavior, your way of talking, you know, some told me while I was asking question in the exam, they behave like they were not a near nursery level student. I found students in the nursery level, those who are in 3 or class 4, they performed better than the people who is performing in this higher education. Why that happens? You are mature, you are graduating, you are getting professional, so you should be behaving professional. Someone was like it was like their hand was like that. What is that? Why you are facing a viva, right? It's a kind of interview. You will be asked questions, you will have to answer questions, right? So there are a lot of things that you will have to consider. So be energetic, enthusiastic, and just be smiling. And sir, after I finish the class, we'll go. Okay, you understand? And listen. So using this behavior, that means during negative half cycle it becomes reverse bias, and during positive half cycle it becomes forward bias. We will see the rectification process. So rectification is a process by which, okay, this is alternating current that we have available, right? This is that form of current we have seen in the very first class, that this form of current, like this becomes, this has a positive peak and negative half cycle, right? Again, positive half cycle and negative half cycle. Okay, once you have a diode, okay, let me tell you what is the rectification process. Rectification process is a process by which we can convert this alternating form of current into pulsating direct current, not a steady direct. Pulsating, that means this, there is still pulse. there will be some, okay, if it is a 5 volt, if it is 5 volt, 0, maybe the 5 is the peak, and then 0 minus 5, right? So once it is rectified, it will become 0, 5, 0, 5, 0, 5. Still there is a pulse, but there is only positive pulse, right? There is no negative pulse, okay. Now, let's see what happened once.
Yes? There is a pulse somewhere, then how it can be received?
It's unidirectional, listen. This so direction is one. This indicates direction. If it comes there, then okay, if it is a resistor, the current will flow in this direction. But for this, what happened here? During this half cycle, across the resistor or across any device, at the first half cycle, the current flows in this direction. At the second half cycle, it flows to the opposite direction. Right? So whatever happens there, the opposite thing is happening here. So that is how it behaves. Right? Okay. Sir, I would take some 15 more minutes.
No problem.
Okay, thank you, sir. Listen. Any question on that? How this alternating voltage and this direct form of current behaves? Okay, listen. It's just one unidirectional, right? Listen. There will be question that what is the rectification? What is the input and what is the output? You have to plot it different ways. So be careful about when taking preparation. Listen. Now, if we have a diode, can you see that?
Yes,
this
sir.
Diode. So if you apply diode here, so this will be the diode. That's the P, and that's the N, right? So these were that was the holes, and that was the electrons, right?
Yes.
So that was the arrangement. So once I connect this diode to this form of power supply, what would happen? Let's see. During positive half cycle, okay, this alternating form of power consists of consists of full cycles. So there are 50 full cycles in a second. That is why we call 50 hertz, right? 1 hertz means 1 full cycle in 1 second. If it is 1 second time, this indicates time, right? This portion indicates time. So if it is time, so there's a positive half cycle and there is a negative half cycle, right? So in 1 second there is a 50 full cycle in the line. So that means 50 times positive half cycle and 50 times negative half cycle. So this positive half cycle, during this positive half cycle, the portion is positive, right? So that means if it is connected to this diode, during positive half cycle, this portion becomes positive and this portion becomes negative. So let's see for now what happens. The P type with positive, P type with a positive, what makes forward bias, what makes this diode what? Forward biased. So I asked you on the exam, how can you make a diode forward biased? So any time the P type with a positive will make it forward biased. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And then after that, listen. After, this is a 1 second, right? So up to 0.5, if you consider that there is 1 hertz, that means this is 1 second,
yes,
in one full cycle, right?
Yes.
So up to 0.5 second, the diode will be forward biased. Why? Because this positive will push these holes towards the junction, and then and the other way the same thing will happen, and the barriers will be eliminated, and some electrons will flow, the current will flow. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So ultimately, up to 0.5 second, what will happen? We see that during positive half cycle, this P will be positive, and N will be negative, because this portion is positive, right? So up to that, the diode is forward biased, right? So once it is forward biased, it will allow the current to pass through, right? So that means we'll get this portion at output. So this portion is appearing for now at output, because the diode is now a conductor. So for now, diode is behaving as a conductor.
Yes, sir.
Okay? next to that. At the next half second, this portion will appear here, right?
Yes.
Because it is as the time progress, it starts continuing, right? So the up to 0.5 second, it was that. And we have seen the output there. And at the next half second, you would see the, this would be negative, because this is the negative portion, right?
Yes.
This would be negative, and this portion will be
positive.
Forget about this portion, just P with a negative. P with a negative will make lots of electrons over there, and these holes will get attracted towards this, and electrons will towards other one. So this will make the barrier very increased. So once the barrier is increased, what will happen? It will be insulator, like it will be an open, something like that. So it's completely an insulator, right?
Yes.
So this will not allow this portion to get an output, because there is no way, right?
Yes.
So that means we'll get a gap.
Gap.
There is nothing in for half cycle, I mean half wave rectifier. Full wave will have different arrangements, so we'll have different outputs. Forget about that. Just let's consider the half wave. So what will happen to the half wave? During positive half cycle, we'll have this positive peak, and during negative half cycle, we'll have nothing, right? It will be space. And after that, come to the next 1 second. That means next 1 second, the positive half will appear at the output a similar way, right?
Yes.
And negative half is not gonna
cough.
It's gonna be off. So that's how it will be. You understand?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So now come to the point. 50 times in a second, this frequency is 50 hertz. 50 times in a second, that is a positive half, that is a negative half. That means 50 times in a second, this diode becomes forward biased and becomes
reverse
biased. So it is on heavy duty, right? Because 50 times it has to conduct and it has been non-conductive, right? It has to change its character 50 times in a second. So that is why we had seen that how diode, what is the character of a diode? We need to know that, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, one thing we'll use that is called oscilloscope. Can you see that? It looks like a television, right?
Yes, sir.
So there is a screen. We would like to would see that. It is amazing to see that this current can be visible. The wave shapes, AC wave shapes, I've seen that's the sinusoidal wave shapes. We would see that once we connect this power to this, it will look like this. It is sinusoidal power. And listen, after we connect things with the rectifier arrangement, then what will happen? It will be rectified, right? First, we'll connect this oscilloscope to the AC, and AC signal will be shown here, right? So there are the port by which we can feed the signal inside. We can feed the signal to the oscilloscope. This is called oscilloscope, right? So oscilloscope is a device that is giving us the wave shapes. We can observe frequencies, right? And we can measure amplitudes and other things with this, right? So there will be questions what this device used for. Okay, listen. And oscilloscope, something else has to tell you. The oscilloscope has got a prop. Let's see.
So this is a
listen, this one is an oscilloscope prop. Oscilloscope prop, I mean, by which we can feed the signal in, right? It's a feeder. So this one, there is a base prop and there is a bypassing prop. Can you see that?
Yes,
this one is the base prop and this one is the bypassing prop. So this base prop is always connected to the phase. AC has got two terminals. Positive phase, you might say phase, and this bypassing lead is always connected to the ground, right? So the bypassing lead is connected to the ground, and base lead is, you know, cushion will be from there. Which one will be connected to the phase? Which one will be connected to the ground? Got it? There will be nothing like I have not prepared for the exam, or I'm this and that. I was this, I was that. So that nothing this will make you smart. Be smart. Once you come and tell me that I was there, I was traveling and all the way, if you are explaining these things, that doesn't make you man. Okay. So this will be plotted here, like this. Now we can feed in the signal. Okay. Now come to the point. I'm drawing the circuit diagram. The circuit diagram is like, we'll have, listen. Listen. We'll have a transformer the very first time. Do you know what the transformer is?
Yes, sir.
The AC voltage is too high. This high voltage can be stepped down to a low voltage.
DC.
With a device, what we know as transformer. Okay, transformer is like, you know, it is working a process, what we know as induction. Okay, how it works, let's see. It is all about the number of turns. Maybe at the primary, a transformer has got two portions, a primary and a secondary. So if you have 220 volt at the primary, 220 volt. So if you take a wire and make turns. So these are the turns here at the primary. And secondary has got also turns. There is no connection between primary and secondary. It's totally separated. Okay. So once you, 220 volt is there in our line, right? So if you have 220 turns like this for 220 volt, so how many voltage per turn? One volt per turn, right? So if you need, why are you talking? Do not talk. Listen. If you need some 12 volt at the secondary, you just give, we know that one volt per turn here, right? So how many turns we need at the secondary? 12 turn. If you give secondary a 12 turn, then 12 volt will be there, induced. If you need 15 volt, just give 15 turn. It all depends on the how many volt per turn here. If we would have given 440 turns for 220 voltages, then one turn would have made
half
voltages. So that means for getting 12 volt, how many turns we would need? 24 turns need, right? So do you understand how transformer works?
Yes.
Right? I would ask questions, that is, how this transformer works. Or if you need some 50 volt here, how many, at the primary if you have this arrangement, at the secondary if you need some 4 volt, how many turns you require? So you have to tell that. Okay. Any question? So there will be transformer at the very first time. And then listen. After that, we'll connect a diode. So that's the P-type of the diode, and that's the N, right? And simply a resistor will be placed. So resistor, why the resistor is placed? To track the output. Resistor is like a pocket here. If you have money, where from the money is collected? From a pocket, right? So money is inside you. So somehow we'll take it out of you from the pocket. So this circuit, this resistor is like a pocket. So this signal that is coming in can be taken out from the across the resistor. If you connect this device in parallel, that means what? Between the two terminal of the resistor, then you will get this output. You understand? Any question? We have had enough idea about how half-wave rectifier works and the circuit diagram. And we'd like to give this AC signal, right? So this AC signal was of 220 volt, and it would step down to some 9 volt or so, right? And then with this rectifier, it will be, with this diode, it will be rectified. During positive half cycle, it will be conducting, and during negative half cycle, it will not conduct. Got it?
Yes.
Any question?
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much. Okay. For now, make groups. Okay, you switch it off, then we'll
not prepare. You have to be prepared. This is your job.
চেহারাটা একটু দেখাও বাবা, এটা নাম যেন কি?
Okay, listen.
Hey, what is the multi? Can you give me a multi-plug?
It's a multi-plug. ওটা এই পাশে নিয়ে আসে। এই একজন এই এই বোর্ডটা কালো বোর্ডটা বোর্ডটা সরাই কালো বোর্ডটা একটু ভিতরে নেন তো, ভিতরে রুমে রেখে আসেন। একজন আমি এটা নিয়ে টানাটা নিয়ে দিচ্ছি। Do it from here, not here. Hey,
We need something to build this circuit, right? What are the things we need?
First, place here. If you look at the circuit diagram, What do you see?
Listen,
I'll show you, right? I'll show things. The first thing we will work with these two things. One is diode and another one is a resistor. These two things we need, and other thing we need a power supply, right? AC power supply. This is a 0 to 9 volt. The transformer I talked about is inserted inside this, and the transformer output 9 volt, 0 to 9. That's the 9 volt transformer output. You understand? Right? So that's the transformer, and this is also AC power supply we have seen at the very first class. The AC can be taken from here, right? So you can take this one or this one. Both of them are transformer output. So we may use this one. Okay. First, start with where?
AC power supply.
I'll show you this, the function of this meter. Okay, somebody switch on. Switch it on. Switch, there is a switch on the other side. We say it, other side. Switch it on. And there is another switch. Yeah. Yes. Okay.
Sir, it is on.
Okay. So, I'm showing you how AC looks like for first time. So let's see how alternating current looks like, and we'll make it pulsating DC, right? Okay. So can you see? This is the ground and this is face. There are two, right?
Yes.
Okay, now this is the feeder. What is the feeder? This is feeder, right? So I talked about this, and I'm talking again. This one is for face, and this one is for ground. So face is this one, right? So this would be connected here, and other one is the ground, will be connected here, right? So I've connected these two and I'm setting it. Can you see AC current? Okay, I'm showing you.
Yes,
can you see the AC current?
Yes.
Now see, I'm increasing frequency, that means number of cycle per second. This is the cycle. As I'm increasing frequency, you see the number of cycle is increasing, right?
Yes.
As I'm decreasing the frequency, number of cycle is decreasing. So do you understand what frequency is?
Yes.
Right? I'm showing you. As I'm increasing frequency, number of cycle is increasing, right?
Yes, sir.
As I'm decreasing frequency, number of cycle is decreasing. Do you want to see that? Do that? I do this. Is it increasing? And decreasing, right? Okay, are you happy? next. Listen, yes.
No, sir, she's
everything
more
to me. Will make us happy. If you do not understand anything, you are not happy with this at all. So until it is clear to you, you're not happy. You should be happy. Chill. You understand everything. Okay, listen. Now, that was the frequency. Another thing that is related to EC is amplitude. Amplitude is the voltage. Maybe 5, maybe 6. 7 is more, right? So let's see amplitude increasing. I'm increasing amplitude. See? That's increase. And I'm decreasing the amplitude. that decrease. Do you see that? Okay. Again, increasing amplitude, decreasing amplitude. Do you see that? Height. Increasing amplitude, decreasing amplitude. Increasing amplitude. Okay? Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Sir, what is amplitude?
Amplitude is the peak. I mean, from I mean, this to this. What is the... Okay. Forget. Okay, listen. I do not see any circuit diagram. Where is the metals? No. Where are the diodes? Where is the thing? It was there. I was explaining about that. Okay. Thank you. I've got it. Okay, listen. We need a resistor, right?
Yes, sir.
Let's talk about the breadboard first. This breadboard is shorted this way. This way they short, right? That means this has a connection with this one. But side by side there is no connection. I'm telling you again. Breadboard are, this is a kind of board. This way they are connected. This area and this area separated. But this area, they are connected this way. Side by side, this hole has got no connection with this hole. But this hole has got connection with this hole. All these, they are connected. So this way they are connected, this way they are not connected. Got it?
Yes.
Okay. First job, I will place a, okay, very first time. Start with the phase, right? Start with wire.
Phase.
What is the circuit diagram? See, this is the phase. This is the transformer secondary. This is the phase, this is the ground, right? So this is the phase, this is the ground. So we'll start, listen, we'll start from the phase, which is here, right? Do you see that? Okay. After that, okay, let us place it here. So this line is connected to the phase, right? So phase is connected to what? P-type, right? So if I connect it here, right? Is that connected with P in the black portion?
Yes,
this phase is connected, they're in the same line. Right? So the phase is connected with the P. Got it? Okay, after that, I'll put it here down. Like this. Okay? Somehow, I have to switch it off. So, can you see this diode? This diode. This diode, the P type is connected to the phase, right? And other terminal, which is N, which is there, where the N is connected? To a resistor, right? So after that, this is a resistor. So if I connect the resistor to the same line, can you see the resistor is connected to the same line?
Yes, sir.
Huh? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
And after that, it will be the other end here. So other terminal of the resistor is connected where? To the ground. You see?
Yes, sir.
Do you see that? That the other terminal of the resistor is connected to the ground?
Yes, sir.
Hmm? Okay. So, this is the ground, right? This is the ground, okay? So, I'm connecting the other terminal of the resistor here, right? This is the ground, right?
Yes, sir.
Is that connected to the ground?
Yes, sir.
Hmm?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, the half-wave rectifier is there. Phase, which is connected to the P-type of the diode, and after the P-type, the N-type of the diode is connected to the resistor, and after the N-type, resistor is connected to the ground. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Where from we will connect, I will take the output between the two terminal of the resistor, here and here, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so how do you see the output? With this feeder, right? Where is the other terminal of the feeder? Okay, here. This feeder, right? So let us disconnect this is the input. Input, we are feeding this signal, right? And at the output, we will observe from here. At the output, between the two terminal of the resistor, right?
Yes, sir.
So one terminal is this. This is connected grounded, right?
Ground.
The other terminal of the resistor, which is connected to the ground. And resistor left with another terminal, which is this, right?
Yes, sir.
So I'm connecting with the other terminal. Can you see?
No, sir.
Huh?
Only positive half cycle is there, right? Negative is?
Yes, sir.
So rectifier is there, right? It is rectified. And now I can increase the frequency. Can you see that? Decrease the frequency. Huh? Is that what I have shown in the diagram? See, during positive half cycle, the diode, this diode becomes forward bias, and it allows this positive half cycle. During negative half cycle, it becomes reverse bias. So there is no signal, straight line. And after that, forward biased, and then reverse bias. Okay? I'm showing you input again. Let's see the input first. This was the input. Can you see that? This was the input. Right? And this is the output. Got it?
Yes, sir.
This is the input. And this was the output. So before the diode, it is input. Right? This is the input. And after the diode, between the resistor, it is output. Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
Is that clear? I'm showing you people. I'm showing you. Before the diode, it is input, AC. And after the diode, it is DC. There is no negative signal. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Any question?
No, sir.
Okay. The other groups. Next group.